So hands into the chest, and we're going to inhale, take the arms wide. So I need to reach up through your fingers, and then exhale, drop the shoulders down. And then we're going to turn the palms, and then reach and fold forward. You just let your forehead fall towards the mat, and then we're going to inhale up onto all fours. And I want you to tuck your toes under, and we're going to exhale, lift the hips back to downward. So squeezing the heels down towards the floor. And then we're going to inhale, look up towards the hands, and step the right foot forward. So back knee comes down, we're going to uncurl the back foot, and then inhale, come up. So I need to bring your right forearm to your thigh, and then we're going to inhale, take the left hand up, reach up through that top hand, really stretch down the torso, and then turn the top hand. We're going to exhale, both hands down either side of the foot. So tucking under the back toe, we're going to inhale, step back, and then squeezing up onto the tips of the toes. We're going to exhale, squeeze the heels down, and then inhale, look up, step the left foot forward, take the back knee down, we're going to uncurl the toe, and then inhale, come up. So shoulders moving away from the ears, and then left forearm down onto the thigh. So we're going to inhale, take the top hand up, so reach up through the fingers, and then turn the top hand, we're going to exhale, both hands down either side of the foot. So tuck under the back toe, inhale, step back, and again, we're going to squeeze up onto the toes, exhale, squeeze the heels down, and then sink in the knees, we're going to drop the belly, and then look up towards the ceiling. So inhale, look up, and then as we exhale, we're going to do the opposite movement. So tuck the tailbone under, press into the hands, arch into the shoulders, and then inhale, belly down towards the floor, looking up towards the ceiling. So as we exhale, we can tuck the tailbone under, try and squeeze the chin in towards the chest, press in towards the hands, and then inhale, belly down, taking the gaze up. So we're going to do it two more times. As we exhale, we need to breathe out as fully as you can. So engaging the core muscles, the abdominal muscles. And then inhale, belly down, and take the gaze up. And then the last time, so really slowing down the out breath, trying to move each piece of the spine bit by bit, so squeezing in. And then as we inhale, we're going to come back to our neutral position. And exhale, sit back on the heels, so just let your forehead move towards the mat. So we're going to inhale, come up onto the knees, take our hands to our hips, and then inhale, start to lift the chest, so keeping the head forward, shoulders away from the ears, and then we're going to exhale, sit back onto the heels. So I need to tuck your toes under now, so we're going to come to standing. So a bit of a challenge for the balance, and we're going to take our hands up. So spread the fingers, shoulders down, and then we're going to inhale, see if we can tip back, and balance on the toes. Cool, so if you don't get it the first time, you can try it a couple of times. So keeping up on the toes, we're going to inhale, come to standing, and then exhale, take the heels down, and then the hands. Cool, so we're going to come towards the middle of the mat now. Feet together, take the shoulders away from the ears, we're going to bring the palms forward. So we're going to inhale, lift the chest, look up towards the ceiling, and then exhale, we're going to bend the knees, fold forward. So rest your chest onto your thighs, and then we can let the head flop down. So we're going to catch hold of the knees, and then inhale, straighten the legs, lift the chest straight back, and then exhale, bending the knees slightly, we're going to step back with the right foot into a low lunge. So I want you to draw that back knee away from the floor, keep the weight off the hands, and then inhale, step the front foot back, we're going to exhale the knees down, and then the chin and the chest. So bend the elbows, and as we inhale, we're going to come up, so I need to keep the elbows bent. Shoulders away from the ear, so we're strengthening the back here too. Tuck the toes under, and then exhale. We're going to press back to our down dog. So I just want you to make sure you've got feet hip width apart, and then we're just going to pedal out your feet. So take one heel towards the floor, and then the other. Don't worry about the heels touching the floor. And then as we inhale, we're going to look up towards the hands and step the right foot forward. So get into our lunge. So back knee away from the floor if you can. And then inhale, the back foot to join. So catching hold of the knees, we're going to inhale, straighten the legs, look forward. And then exhale, bend the knees, rest the chest onto the thighs, drop the forehead. And we're going to inhale, look up, take the hands out, roll up the spine. Inhale, look up, lift the chest. And then exhale, the hands back down. Good, so we're going to turn to face the front now. And I want you to bring your feet hip width apart, tuck the toes in. So hands onto the waist. Keep the knees soft, and then we're going to exhale and just roll forward and just let our head and our hands hang. So from here, we can spend a bit of time here, and then I just want you to catch hold of the elbows of the hands. So adding a bit of weight, and then keeping the neck floppy, we're going to inhale, start to straighten the legs if we can. We
can keep the knees bent and rest the chest on the thighs. So we can start to move our hands now around the backs of the legs. So as we inhale, we need to look up and then keeping the legs straight if you can, lift the chest, straighten the arms. And then as we exhale, we're going to aim to tuck our elbows somewhere behind the legs, but just moving in that general direction rather than using the hands to pull. And then we're going to inhale and look up, and then bend the knees, hands onto the hips, and we're just going to roll the spine back up to standing. So I want you to step the feet wide now. We're going to keep the hips forward, and then tuck the left toes in, turn the right toes back. So bringing the hips forward, inhale, raise the hands, and we're going to reach out through the fingers. So press into the fingers on either side of the room, and then we're going to exhale, reach over that extended leg as far as we can, and then just drop the hand down and see where it goes. So you're going to inhale, reach up through that top hand, and then we're going to tuck the chin in, see if we can look up towards the thumb. So we should be feeling the stretch down the torso, we're rolling that top shoulder back, looking up towards the thumb, and then we're going to inhale, look down towards the toes, bend the knee, and then inhale the hands up. So to swap sides, we're just going to tuck the toes in to turn the face the other way, bring the hips forward. Again, inhale, reach into the hands. So we're going to exhale, reach over that extended leg, and then drop the hand down, just see where it goes. So when we inhale, we're going to reach up through that top hand, really lift the chest, and then tuck the chin in, see if we can look up towards the thumb. So just staying in each posture for a few breaths. We can stay for up to 10 if we want. And then we're going to turn the gaze down towards the big toe, bend the knee, and then inhale, come all the way back up. So we can turn the toes to face the front, and then we can just step the feet back together. So we're going to come onto the mat now. So come onto the knees, and we're going to do some work on our core before we do some work on stretching out the muscles of the legs. So I want you to bring your forearms down so that your elbows are underneath the shoulder, so not too wide, not too narrow, to give yourself a good base. So tuck the toes under, and as we inhale, we're just going to lift the hips up. Don't worry about whether your heels go down towards the floor. So I want you to keep the gaze up, look towards the fingers. So if this is already hard enough, you can just stay here. Otherwise, we're going to exhale and see if we can bring our head over the fingers. And we might be able to hold from anything from 1 to 10 breaths, but just build it up rather than trying to overwork. So we're going to inhale, lift up, press down through the hands. And then if you need a break here, you can take the knees down or we can go again. So exhale, hover the chin over the hands, and then inhale, pushing ourselves back up. So we're just going to drop the knees for a break. You can rest the forehead down. And then as we inhale, we're going to come up, same position, clasp hold of the hands. So if that was already hard enough, just repeat that same exercise again. Otherwise, we're going to tuck the toes under, lift the hips. And then this time as we exhale, we're going to bring our right knee in towards the top of our arm, so in towards the armpit. So again, we can hold from anything from 1 to 10 breaths if you feel like torturing yourself. And then we're going to step the foot back. Again, you can take the knees down if you need a break. Otherwise, we're going to exhale and then bring our left knee in towards our shoulder, in towards our armpit. And then pushing the toes back, we're going to take the knees down, unclasp the hands. And then just exhale, rest the forehead. So just allow yourself to rest until your breath goes back to normal. And then we're going to inhale, come up onto all fours. And then just step the feet forward. And then we're going to come to sit down. So we're going to do some work on the legs now. So just make sure your hips are as even as they can be. So we're going to take our hands in towards our chest. And then inhale, take the arms wide. So reach up as far as you can, and then we're going to turn the palms, and exhale, reach as far forward as you can. So don't worry about where the hands go, just drop the hands. So anywhere along the leg, and we're going to inhale, lift the chest, look up. So shoulders down, lower back moving in, looking forward, and then we can just drop the head slightly to take the gaze down. And then we're going to hold, so anything up to 5 breaths. And then inhale again, see if you can straighten the arms a bit more, lift the chest. And this time you might be able to exhale, you can creep the fingers down, or if your hands are on your feet, you might be able to take them to the sides of your feet. So we're going to inhale, lift, and then exhale, look down, and you might be able to bend the elbows and fold a bit more. So we're going to inhale, look up, and then come back up to seated. So we're going to face this way now to do some work on the glutes, and we're going to start on the right side. So I want you to bring
your left foot or your left shin parallel to the top of the mat, and then we're going to stack the right foot on top. So if you can't get your heels and your knees in line, you can bring your feet further away, you can cross the legs, or you can use a block like Charlie, just something like a big book maybe to put underneath, and we're going to bring our fingers out in front of us. So press into the tips of the fingers. So first of all, we're going to inhale, lift the chest. We probably will already start to feel something from here. This is my top pose for cyclists. And then we're going to exhale, creep the fingers forward. So work slowly, don't go beyond where you can go at this moment in time. If you start to feel like something's sticking a bit, you just stay there, hold and breathe. And then as we inhale, we might be able to push into the hands again, lift the chest, and you might be able to creep the fingers a bit further or take the forearms down. So again, once the forearms are down, we're going to inhale, keep lifting the chest, looking forward. And then as you exhale again, you might be able to creep the fingers a bit more. You might be able to take the forehead down. It doesn't matter if you can't get the forehead down. We're just going to keep pressing into the hands, and you can just drop the gaze down. So to swap sides, we're going to use the fingers to bring us back up. And then we're just going to unstack the leg. So whatever leg you've got on top now, you're going to place it underneath, and then place the opposite foot on top. So again, it might be easier on one side than the other, but move the feet further away, cross the legs if you need to, and then we're going to bring the fingers out towards the front of the shins. So inhale, start to lift the chest, look up, and then as we exhale, we're going to start the process again. So start to creep the fingers forward. It might be easier on this side, might be a bit harder. You might be able to get the forearms down. Wherever the hands are there, we're going to use that inhale to lift the chest, look up. And then exhale, start again. So creep the fingers or just take the gaze down and hold. But just hold at the point where it's the hardest for you, not impossible. That's the difference. So to inhale, we're going to use the fingers to press ourselves back up. And then we're going to unstack the feet. So we're going to turn back to face this way. So coming up onto all fours. And we're going to slide ourselves down so our bellies are on the front of the mat. So we're going to bring our left forearm out in front of us to help stabilise us, so in line with the top of the mat. And then looking back towards the toes, we're going to reach back with the right hand, pick up the right toes if you can. So just catch hold of the toes. This might already be enough. If this is okay, we're going to turn the fingers towards us, bring the elbow up towards the ceiling. And as we inhale, we're going to press into that forearm on the front of the mat, lift the chest, and then exhale. See if we can squeeze the heel in towards our lower back. We're in towards our buttock, not moving the foot out towards the side so that we're protecting the knees here. Good. So as we inhale, we're going to let go and then we're going to swap sides. So bringing the opposite hand out in front of us to help brace ourselves, and then we're going to inhale, reach back with the left, see if we can pick up the left toes. So staying here, we're going to turn the fingers to face us, bring the elbow upwards, and then inhale, lift the chest, and then as we exhale, see if we can squeeze the heel in towards us. So stretching out the front of the thighs, and then we're going to exhale, release, and come back down. So staying on the front of our mat, we're going to slide the hands back towards the hips and take the forehead down. So just going to set ourselves up by squeezing the legs in towards each other. So toes, heels, knees, thighs, and then we're going to push down with the fingers. And as we inhale, we're going to lift our chest away from the mat, so shoulders moving away from the ears. You can press into the hands, reach down, and then lift up the toes, and then last of all, see if we can lift up the hands. So you can stay here, work on this one for 5 breaths, and then we're going to inhale, reach the hands forward. So see if you can bring the hands forward and press through the fingers, draw the shoulders down, and then to finish off, we're going to exhale, draw the elbows in, a bit like we're making a W shape with the arms, so palms facing down. Inhale, you might be able to lift the chest up a bit more, and then we're going to exhale, drop the forehead down, drop the hands. So just let your breath return to normal here. A bit hard to breathe when we're led on the front of our chest. And then keeping the hands underneath the shoulders, we're going to inhale up onto all fours, and then to finish off, we're going to give ourselves a break. So bring your knees as wide as the mat, toes touching, and then we're going to exhale, sit back towards the heels, and then you can just drop the forehead down. And then we're going to stay here until you feel ready to get up, until you have enough time to recover, and then we can practice it again tomorrow.